This video, we're going to talk about various types of grip training and how that's important and how that's implicated for the overhead throwing athlete. And then some novel ways that we can actually train grip strength and forearm strength for the throwing motion. There are a lot of ways to improve grip strength and ultimately forearm strength for the throwing athlete. And we wanted to talk about this a little bit because we've had some questions. Isn't grip strength going to be better because it can stabilize the elbow joint based on the finger flexors that actually cross the elbow? And the answer is yes, sure. We got to think about other forearm muscles as well that really don't cross the fingers, aren't implicated in gripping, but do stabilize the medial elbow. And we also have to think about, you know, epicondylitis, epicondylosis, like medial epicondylitis, where we actually get a little leaguer's elbow or inflammation around the tendons that insert or originate at the medial epicondyle. And while we have a lot of different techniques to improve grip strength, the ones that are going to be most effective to the throw or correlate most to what we actually think is going on with the tendons that cross the elbow there, over the medial or attached to the medial epicondyle, what's going to be most specific to what we found there, and then how we can train that for the throwing athlete. So yeah, we can give athletes, you know, some sort of gripper, and yes, it will attack the finger flexors, the grip muscles, as well as some intrinsic muscles in the hand. But if I can put a baseball in the athlete's hand and then have them go through wrist motions that are going to facilitate strengthening some of the other muscles like the flexor carpi, ulnaris, or pronator teres that lie on the inside of the elbow and are going to be more important in the dynamic stabilization of the elbow while they have to incorporate a grip component, I'm going to be most effective. So you'll see here, we got an exercise where I actually have a band wrapped around baseball. And I could use a softball, I could use any ball. A smushier ball can make the exercise more difficult in terms of grip, but maybe less specific in terms of the sensory feedback that the athlete gets through your hand. And then they can provide resistance by stepping out farther and then performing various wrist actions that could be specific to the pitch they want to perform. Or I can target those muscles by actually applying a valgus load in someone that's healthy. So I just have to consider, is this athlete healthy? What is the status of the medial elbow? Do they have a partial UCL tear? Have they had little leaguer's elbow? Are they recovering from something? Are they completely healthy, asymptomatic? And then how much load can I effectively apply without causing a negative stress reaction that's going to result in pain, injury, or, you know, deformation of the ligamentous structures down the road. So I often use a valgus load where I'll go through various wrist motions, or I'll hold a position isometrically and then do a subscap exercise at the shoulder that will teach the muscles that they have to activate to stabilize the elbow at the same time that they're being that a inertial load will be applied distally in the throw. So when I actually throw, there's an inertial load here at the wrist because we have a fulcrum, or here at the hand because there's a fulcrum, and then at the elbow as well. So, you know, it's important to consider all aspects of what's going on in the exercise. Definitely try this out. Be a little creative in how you use a band and a ball in your grip strengthening exercises that then you can incorporate in your subscap exercises, your rotator cuff exercises, and then ultimately with the other forearm musculature to resist the stresses of the throw. If you like the video, hit the thumbs up. Let us know in the comments section. We want to put out content that you guys want to see, and we're constantly answering questions that you guys ask us through direct message, email, questions that we get from our athletes here in person. Whatever the case is, let us know what you want to see from us, and then make sure to subscribe so you don't miss it when we actually publish the video that you're looking to watch.